Sustainable Civilization Strategies. One Community Weekly Progress Update, number 259.
One Community is a 501c3 nonprofit organization. We are creating open source and free shared blueprints and resources, tools and tutorials, and do-it-yourself instructions for highest good living. Creating solution models that create additional solution creating models in the service of all life on this planet.
My name is Jay Sable. I'm the executive director of the One Community 501c3 nonprofit organization. This is our weekly progress update number 259, March 11th, 2018 edition. Let's talk sustainable civilization strategies. Why? Well, because how effective and productive would it be if our governments said that their goal was to create a sustainable civilization? I mean, how much of a good idea would it be if we as a people, we as a society, we as a civilization said, hey, you know what? The goal is to become sustainable. Because if we're not sustainable, if we're not choosing sustainability, then what are we choosing? And if what we're doing isn't sustainable, by definition, it cannot sustain itself, which means it will come to an end. And so we believe that the time is now. And we brought together our team of all volunteers to create sustainable civilization strategies. And what you see in the background here is a series of the village models, the sustainable village models that we are designing and developing as a sustainable civilization strategy. The bigger picture being taking all the foundations of physical sustainability, which are food, energy, and housing, and combining them with the emotional foundations of sustainability, which we've identified as fulfilled living practices, highest good education models, highest good economic models, and true earth stewardship. And putting these things together, creating open source and free shared sustainable civilization strategies built on models for teacher demonstration, communities, villages, cities, and hubs designed to teach others how to create teacher demonstration communities, villages, cities, and hubs too. Spreading around the world as a global cooperative and a global collaborative working together to create even more open source tools, tutorials, resources, and do-it-yourself instructions for all the aspects of our project. And operating one community as a teacher demonstration hub that people can come and visit, experience, and see if they believe that's a sustainable civilization strategy that they'd like to implement as well. And creating it all so it is modularly implementable. And so each component can be implemented if people aren't interested in the complete model. And so the complete model in the Teacher Demonstration Hub can be implemented as a way of living that we think that most people will consider to be better than the way they're living right now. And so if we can make this idea easy enough, affordable enough, and demonstrate as attractive enough, the idea will spread on its own. And we have the ability to touch the lives of everybody on our planet. Doesn't mean everybody has to participate, but we can reach that tipping point of finally creating a sustainable civilization, making humanity sustainable, moving away from destructive practices and moving towards things that are regenerative, things that give more to the people, give more to the local communities, give more to their countries, and give more to the planet than they take. Because right now we are taking more than we give, and we believe it's time for those that see this as not so intelligent and see and realize that we have the technology, the knowledge, and the willpower now to create a world that truly works for everybody. And bringing those people together, people with a consciousness for the highest good of all, that want to make a better world for everybody. This is what we're doing. This is what we're doing. Creating sustainable civilization strategies that are open source and free shared so that people can implement them in their lives in the way that they want to. But for those that really want to be proactive, either joining our organization or creating their own teacher demonstration hub, to create a way of living that will provide more free time, more abundance, and more things to do with that free time and that abundance than traditional living models. Far superior to traditional living models and a way of living that most people we think will consider to be way better than the way they're living right now, so it'll spread on its own. And we see sustainable civilization strategies as not necessarily having to be just the comprehensive model. Like open sourcing the entire process of how we're open sourcing things is also part of our project. We see that as a cornerstone, as a foundation of creating a world that works for everybody, is free sharing the information that people need to live a life that is sustainable, to be stewards if they want to be stewards, but at least to live a life that's sustainable or to introduce more sustainable practices in their life if they're interested in doing that. And so we are open sourcing and free sharing everything that we're doing to do that, That's a big part of our sustainable civilization strategy and what One Community is all about. And as we build One Community, as we invite people to come and visit, experience the lifestyle, experience all the aspects of what it is that we're doing, because everything is open source and free shared, because we're working so hard now, today, right now, our all-volunteer staff, to open source and free share every step of the process, from the taxes, to the food, to the housing infrastructure, to the education model, to our social media strategy, you name it. If it's important and helpful and we think it can help the world, we are open sourcing and free sharing it for that purpose. We think it's time. We think it's time to create a world that works for everybody. And so everything you see happening in the background of the video here is our process of doing that. And we build One Community, and you're invited to visit and come and see what it is. You're invited to participate. There's lots of different ways. And as we do this, if we can make it easy enough, affordable enough, and demonstrate it's attractive enough, if One Community can inspire two additional communities once we start building to start up, and then those two can help inspire four more, and then eight more, and then 16 more each year, if we can just double the number of people we inspire because we are growing our group, if we can do that, we can transform our world into a sustainable one within our lifetime. Within our lifetime, within about 30 years. And this is what One Community is doing. So we're an all-volunteer organization, we're 100% unpaid staff, we're a nonprofit organization, and we are open sourcing and free sharing sustainable civilization strategies for everybody. So with that said, here is 1 week of our team's progress and accomplishments working towards that goal. Check it out.
The One Community approach to highest good housing is eco-artistic home building that is affordable, sustainable, do-it-yourself duplicable, resource and space efficient, and consists of 7 different sustainably constructed village models. This week, the core team continued working on the 7 Villages online book. This week, we continued updating the formatting and imagery for pages 44 to 47, as shown here. And the core team continued working on the Murphy bed instructions by creating and adding the stain page to the book, as shown here. The core team also created the first 30% of the Treehouse Village Pod 7 cost analysis page, some of which you can see here. Mike Kowalski, game developer, joined the team to help with updating our Recycled Materials Village Pod 6 renders that are too big for anything but a gaming computer. You can see the beginnings of Mike's review process here. Dean Schulz, architectural designer, continued with the Cobb Village Pod 3 AutoCAD layout updates. Here's update 104 of Dean's work, and this week he added new windows, doors, and furniture to the social spaces and started adding landscaping elements. Dan Alec, designer and illustrator, completed his 15th week working on the compressed earthblock village render additions. This week he finished work on this massage room looking northwest. The image is on the site now too. And Jagannathan Shankar Mahadevan, mechanical engineer, completed his 18th week volunteering and finished all the calculations for the Cobb Village cost analysis page. What you see here is a sample of this work that includes the materials, equipment, furniture, and more. Jagannathan also then wrote the entire narrative for the page, some of which is shown here. Michelle Pinzaru, interior designer and architectural drafter, completed her 8th week working on the Treehouse Village Pod 7 residential designs. This week she continued working on the final texturing and lighting details for the interior. You can see some of this work here. One Community is also creating an open source duplicable city center. It is designed to be LEED Platinum certified, provide 12 guest rooms, dining for over 150 people, and laundry and recreation space for over 300 people, all while saving money, time, space, and resources. This week, the core team completed a thorough review of the second half of the City Center Structural Engineering Dead and Live Load Report, shown here. David Olivero, mechanical engineer and data scientist, completed his 13th week helping with the HVAC designs for the duplicable city center. This week's focus was researching and further developing the related equipment plan. You can see some of this work here. One Community's approach to highest good food is duplicable almost anywhere, scalable for different needs, more biodiverse and nutritious, part of forwarding a global open source botanical garden collaborative, and includes 9 different free shared and duplicable growing environments. This week, the core team continued research and design of the open source climate battery designs. What you see here is the continued process of integrating climate batteries into the phase 2 food plans that include the aquapenis and wallapenis.
One community's approach to highest good education is designed for all age groups, adaptable to any schooling environment, inspiring and fun for all participants, includes national standards, all subjects, lesson plans, teaching strategies, learning strategies and tools, classroom design, and more. This week, the core team continued developing the lesson plan's how-to tutorial page. We added a new how to create your individualized lesson plan section, doubled the details in the beginning learners example, and finished the first 50% of the intermediate learners example.
The one community approach to highest good society is globally focused, individually enriching, cooperative and collaborative, includes a highest good network and application, 4 different economic models, and combines fulfilled living and true earth stewardship for the benefit of all people and all life on this planet.
The Highest Good Network software team consists of Samya Manohar, Priti Kodari, Shubhar Mittal, Priyanka Singh, and Asha Tatamari. This week, the team continued working on making the badges dynamic and also updated the profile form so a user can edit their personal information, so an administrator can edit personal administrative information, and so any individual can see anybody else's information in a read-only mode. They also worked on the projects page to display the project's details.
Well, there you have it. That is our idea of sustainable civilization strategies and our process for creating it, 1 week of our accomplishments. If you'd like to see more details, more specifics, links to all the open source details, everything that we're creating, visit our written blog, visit our website, everything is there. If you'd like to see an email every time one of these updates comes out, send an email to onecommunityupdates@gmail.com and we will happily add you to our newsletter list, and you'll get one email a week from us with this update in it. And last but not least, join us on social media, subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you like the easiest way to support us, well, you can visit our helping page. There's lots of different ways to do that. But just joining us on social media and liking our posts or helping share our posts really helps to get the word out. And so if you're somebody that's already doing that, thank you. If you're looking for an easy way to help out and get involved, that's the easiest way. And we are on all the different social media networks to make it as easy as possible. Google our name and whatever your social media network is that you're interested in, we're probably there because we're on all the big ones. We're on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Tumblr, Reddit, Pinterest, Instagram, and about 15 other social media networks to make it as easy as possible for people to access our information. So join us there if you're interested. And last but certainly not least, thank you. Thanks for following our project. Thank you for the support that you're giving. Thanks for watching to the end. If you're somebody who's donated to our project, as I said before, we're 100% unpaid staff. So every donation goes 100% to forwarding our mission and forwarding and the website infrastructure and things like that. None of it goes to paychecks. It goes to keeping everything that we're doing open source and free shared. You notice there's no advertising on our website. There's no advertising on our YouTube videos. It helps us continue to do that. So if you're somebody who's donated to us, thanks. It makes a big difference. We do appreciate it. And until next week, we will keep on keeping on with our sustainable civilization strategies. Thanks.